At the end of the day, what we want is to understand the laws of nature. How did all this structure in the universe form, and where do we come from? If you want, this is the main goal at the end, to just better understand the way how nature works. I am Lavinia Heisenberg. I am an assistant professor here at ETH, at the Institute for Theoretical Physics. I work on questions related to gravity and cosmology. When you go on cosmological scales, on large scales, the gravitational force is the dominant one. So if you want to describe the nature or the physics behind the universe, you need to know what is the fundamental law of gravity. Our research is driven by the following fundamental questions. What sets gravity apart from the other interactions? What are the essential and fundamental properties of gravity? How can we combine in a consistent way gravity with quantum theories? And lastly, how can we use astrophysical and cosmological observations to extract fundamental knowledge about gravity? Usually in all other disciplines, you can really build your own experiment and manipulate it and change a few things here and there. But if you are an astrophysicist or cosmologist, we can't do that really. What we can only do is basically try to observe the universe. All the information so far that we had about the universe was coming only through the photons, through light. And now we have also this new channel of gravitational wave observations. And if you want, you can compare it with the situation as if we were completely blind and suddenly we can actually see in all these beautiful colors. This is just complementary information. And actually, until now, we had only one event of two neutron stars merging. By this event, then they sent both electromagnetic signal as well as gravitational wave signal. And now if you compare these two channels, when these signals arrive, you can then actually tell about the speed of gravitational waves. And with just one event, we observed that the gravitational waves propagate with the speed of light. I am rather an optimist, and I think if you combine now all these precision measurements coming from gravitational waves with all the observations that we already had through light, I think at the end of the day we will come closer to what is really the true nature of gravity. For me, apart from research, the teaching part is very important. This is something that I really enjoy very much. I like to give lectures and to interact directly with students. And I think the way how you do it is going to influence a lot how they pursue physics and research in general. When I teach, I try to see that as a research project. I try to learn more about it, and I write things down, and I read about it, or I take some courses and try to improve that. I think it's also very important that already girls at school or young female researchers have actually this role model. And I myself, I had them, and I am really thankful for having had those role models. And it's also something that I would like to pass on and also give to the generation just coming after me. Sometimes life as an assistant professor can be quite challenging. You have to excel in research, you have to have a very well-functioning group, you have to be excellent in teaching and a very great supervisor. I think it's important that you develop some sort of high tolerance for frustration. I go for running, or I do bouldering and also archery. Because it needs such a high concentration, you can be actually there at the moment. What I do, or what I try to do, is some sort of a meditation, and that I achieve usually by listening to classical music. Curiosity was always the driving force for me. And I think one of the reasons why I went into astrophysics or cosmology was because I wanted to become an astronaut. To see Earth from such a perspective, it must be an amazing feeling to see how fragile our Earth is. There's so much unknown out there, and we should just keep exploring.